I mean, it's utterly original. It's so good. You're so gifted, Brad.
Hey.
And Monique. Monique, yeah, I'm saying Monique. She is a great character.
Thank you. Man, what a kick. Elise Elliott in a Brett Artunian film.
So tell me, how do you see her?
Well, I think we go for grotesque.
Cooperation. Allie, I'll be with you in a few minutes, okay?
No problem.
It's the easiest interrogation of my crime-filled life.
I'm gonna go get a quick cup of coffee. You want?
Want some soup?
How you doing? You all right?
Not at all. You know, I knew this was coming. I knew this wasn't over.
You are not alone, Sid. Okay, we are all here for you.
Exactly as you predicted. Quick, drive my car.
Here's $40.
If you don't mind me asking, how did you know he'd react like that?
It's our job to know things like that.
You done this sort of thing before?
Let's go!
You can take the car, but remember, it's stolen.
Always liked the South, so when we finished college, we decided to settle down here and have a family. I used to be a flower child. You know what a flower child is?
A kid with flowers?
Not exactly. Close, though. But now I have to be low-key so I can hold a steady job. Oh, boy, when I was young, kiddo, I wanted to save the world.
What from?
Well, from people like your father.
You mean there's more like him?
Lots more. Too many.
My Aunt Nadine says my daddy was a mistake for me.
Lieutenant.
Folks in Britain, yo. God, what is that foul smell?
We walked these all the way from Chinatown.
What is it? It
smells like a dead cat.
It's this fruit.
Yeah, from Indonesia.
It's called durian.
It's like papaya, man, but it's like got these psychoactive qualities. It's amazing. Here, have a piece.
Well, it does not smell like papaya. Oh my God, not, I implore you, not in here.
Hey, come on,
hey,
man.
Come on, I told you, man. I didn't know it was going to smell like a rotting corpse.
Andrew, I faxed you that thing, man.
Yeah, it's not that bad.
It's supposed to be like safe LSD.
Oh, what's going on?
Terry, I'm so glad.
Hello, Mr. Repairman. Being a housewife is so boring.
I can, just that for you, ma'am.
So how do we get on top of this motherfucker?
These, Galvanators are tricky.
No.
No, you don't want to get laid, or no, you do, but you don't want to get laid with me.
Look, they'll be here.
They'll be here. Are you a virgin?
What?
Come on, Claire. Answer the question. Answer the question, Claire.
Just save it. Don't really want to hear it.
Just want to know how Spaz is.
That fucking lot, you care.
That lot, isn't that a British expression?
I put fucking in it, so now it's American.
So what's with Spaz?
He's okay.
propped up in bed, surrounded by pillows, looking like a Puerto Rican bride doll.
So he's...
He's fine.
So buggy what he did? Jumping in the water like that? Buggy.
Go away.
From the three of us. Aww.
And you wrapped it in your pants.
Funny. Right? Funny. Well,
very funny. Love, here I am.
Yeah, it's a joke. You know how, like, you're the only one of us that never complains about not having a boyfriend?
Yeah. Certain individuals less familiar with the real Dennis might interpret that absence of desire to couple as a defense mechanism, a wall, in which case this text would serve you in overcoming your emotional blockage and opening yourself up to the possibilities of...
I told you a lot of things he didn't tell you about me.
No.
He didn't mention nothing about our business together.
What do you want?
I'm sorry. I mean, I figured you and I got something in common. Augie, his well-being. Has he been acting strange?
Augie is doing just fine.
Insurance?
What?
He mentioned anything about insurance.
Hey, Fuzzy.
Aw, shit, what are you doing here? I told you I don't know anything.
Yeah, but you're a liar.
You're gonna get me fired, man.
Fired? That's not good. You're on parole, right?
Fuzzy, hey. Nobody wants to get you fired. We just need his information, is all.
2 weeks ago, a call came in for a lot of top-end cars.
And who made that call?
I don't have a clue.
Okay, I'm just gonna go talk to your boss.
Oh, shh. The delivery date. I know the delivery date.
And when is that?
Thursday, Friday, end of the week.
I don't want to bother you. I just wanted to apologize about the other day. It hasn't been good for me not to talk about the things that have happened. And I think if I did, I think if we did that, then maybe I wouldn't have done some of the things that I've done. I'm sorry. I'll go.
Where'd you get that?
Michael?
Oh, shit. Amanda, this isn't what it looks like.
Huh. It looks like you're having sex with the woman from the cover of the lingerie catalog. In our bed.
Oh.
Dude, I just keep putting this shit on until I want to fuck myself.
Hey, Rob, you wearing underwear?
No.
Rob? You wear
underwear. I know the drill, no panties.
Rob?
No.
Rob, get up.
I am not freezing my balls off.
Just stand up and drop it.
I'm not taking it off.
Rob,
what? Oh, if you want to take them off, take them off. I am not taking my... Oh!
You're a woman, then.
After we come up with the small wager, say $50.
What's the subject?
In the movies, when people wake up together in the morning, they immediately start kissing, nuzzling, and going at it. But what they never do is get up first, take a leak, and brush their goddamn teeth. Which I don't think I'm alone in feeling is pretty much necessary when you wake up.
Oh, what's it called when you got a constant woody and it won't go down?
You mean priapism.
See, I'm practically pre-asthmic.
Priapismic.
Whatever, it's hard.
That's what you're betting on?
No, I'm saying I can name the one movie.
Goodbye.
Hi, boss. How's it going?
Good. Hey, how long has that clown in the truck been out there?
I don't know.
From me. What are you gonna do?
I don't have to do anything. Hugo Posh will. Yeah, he's my partner on this 50-50. So, could I please have my tape back?
Fuck you! Fuck you. I'm taking your half then.
No, that money's going to Sam Young. The money you stole from him.
You say that like I care. I don't give a shit.
I think I should have called. But you're probably busy or on your way out or... God, you could be seeing someone by now. I hadn't thought of that. Someone you met in a normal, uncomfortable...
Matthew! Hi, okay. I'm doing it. I know.
McClane, would you do me a favor? I know the lights are beginning to dim, but if you could just hang on for a second, as soon as Matt's finished, I'm gonna kill him and your daughter, and I would love for you to see that. God damn it. Matthew?
Проверьте на балконе с другой стороны. Центр. Каждый приходит ниже.
What the hell is going on out here?
It's me.
I can see that. I filed a restraining order against you.
Well then, congratulations. Looks like you got your top story for tonight.
This is not gonna look good.
I don't care how it looks.
I can't be involved in this. Take your husband and leave.
Don't speak to me like I'm some groupie you just fucked.
Honey! I just want you off my property. Yeah.
Give me that!
Put your hands off me!
Ah, I'm sorry. I knew you died. Your hell!
Phil!
I apologize, sir!
Phil! You are gonna get arrested!
Let me see that hair! Johnson! Action news! Phony apologize!
Greg says, stop loss is only in a time of war. This president said the war's over, so legally...
New lawyer, Sonny.
No, sir. But after doing right by this army, I'm getting burned by some fine print in a contract. Now, the president himself said...
The president is also the commander-in-chief. I think he trumps you either way.
With all due respect, sir, fuck the president.
Fuck the president.
Yes, sir. He's not over there fighting this war. He's not there seeing his buddies burned alive in Humvees. I lost 3 men last month.
Environmental services attendant.
A laundry maid.
No, it's more like a...
That's a good job for you. You always were a very clean guy.
Right.
Cleanest cell on the block. Always appreciated that.
When did you get out?
Now.
Today?
Yeah, I took a bus from jail and took another bus here.
You came straight here?
I heard you were here, so I'm here.
Jesus.
What?
Huh?
Oh, nothing. Come here.
Place on earth, asshole.
Russ, I want to talk to him.
What do you think you are?
I'm the guy standing between you and a bullet.
What was on that plane? What was on that goddamn plane?
Trixie. Rhabdo Verde prototype.
A fucking biological weapon!
It was
weapon.
Headed to an incinerator in Texas.
You're telling me that you guys engineered this crap?
It's designed to destabilize a population.
Hey.
Hey.
I was waiting for my realtor. I'm looking for an apartment on the on another floor.
Oh, yeah?
Can I be honest with you?
Okay.
I was going to ask you if I could come in and take a look at your apartment, you know, to see if I wanted to buy or not. But that would be a total lie.
Lie?
I'm just looking for an excuse to get into your place.
Get through the firewall. We have to go there and take it down ourselves. Mog, see this? Just a matter of time.
Pack your stuff. We're leaving.
I'm not going.
I'm sorry. What did you say?
I'm not going.
Okay. If you want to pick the next place, that's
fine. It's not my fight, and it never was. I can't even remember a war before this one.
Wait. Is this because of a girl? Go upstairs and get your stuff.
When I played, and you were coaching, what were the parents like? Were they like these idiots?
I don't know. I didn't know most of them.
You didn't know them?
No. How would I get to know them? They drop off their kids, they leave.
They didn't even hang out.
No. Why would they hang out? Parents got things to do. What's wrong with you people? That's what's wrong with you people. You're so involved. You know, playing catch with your kids is good. Showing up and saying, hey, nice.
Hey, Sunflower.
Hey, Ari.
Hey, are the boys' passports up to date?
Their passports?
I am planning our summer vacation.
Okay. Where, are you planning this vacation?
We're going to Paris. Tina's never been.
Paris, France?
Uh-huh.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not. Why?
I gotta go. Bye.
Hello?
Hey, man. I just got a D-Rog for doing my job.
Politics, man. Culture of fear wins again.
I can't get anything done here.
Yeah.
Hey, what about that idea that we were talking about?
I'm working on it. I'm waiting for a call back from our friend at the Hill.
Who, Corbin? You called Corbin? Mm-hmm. Do you think you can do something?
We'll see. Maybe some limited field ops under my supervision.
Yes, that'd be amazing. I would
easy,
love
it. Easy, Ed. I've got to see a cleric in Merlon. We'll talk after.
Okay.
This next one I did not write. But I think you'll dig it anyway. I met the gal who did write it on top of a water tower in a rainstorm in Poughkeepsie. I was 19, and I was off my face on a bottle of the hard stuff. Stumbling through this field.
Fine. Go fetch her and tell her what?
Go fetch her and tell her I'll give her a fat $5 gold piece.
Right, go fetch her and tell her I'll give her a fat $5 gold piece. She play her little chili pepper heart out, right?
Right.
Got it. I ain't gonna hurt her. I just want her to play the fiddle. Now go fetch her and tell her I'll give her a fat $5 gold piece. She play her little chili pepper heart out. Gone.
George Hurst, come out now.
Identify the man hired you to do Charlie Utter's murder.
I've been noticing you're acting sort of funny.
What do you mean, funny?
You know, with that thing, all that's going on. You're distracted.
Not distracted.
Sweet Tiny Jesus. What the hell is that? Dumb selfie? Everyone is distracted. Nobody works.
Okay, Travis, you know that I have to go to that meeting again in Rosewood tonight, so maybe we can...
Again?
Just pick... Well, that's... Every Tuesday is gonna be at least once a week, so.
See, that's what I'm talking about. You're my right-hand man, Lily, but your mind's not in the game.
Hey.
Hi. A poet at a football game.
Philosopher at a football game. Anyway. You look fantastic.